Comparison of antioxidant activity in three popular coffee brands. Research done by Kelly and Jesse. Why coffee? Coffee is one of the most traded commodities in the world, as well as one of the most consumed beverages. It is most known for its caffeine content, which contributes to increased alertness, energy, and concentration. Coffee has been linked to improved levels of cognitive performance and physical endurance. Many college students, including ourselves, drink coffee daily. Despite past claims that coffee is bad for one's health, most recently, coffee has been recognized for its antioxidant activity and health benefits. Some studies suggest that even more antioxidant activity is seen in coffee than in red wine or green tea, as well as a number of health advantages have been reported, including lower risk of certain types of cancer, particularly colon and liver cancer. Previous research shows that whether one drinks instant or brewed coffee does not affect the amount of antioxidants consumed. Although the antioxidant capacity in instant coffee has been found to be about 3 to 4 times higher than in ground coffees, when brewing coffee, people generally use an amount 4 times larger than the amount of instant coffee for the same volume of water. Therefore, no matter which method is used, antioxidant activity consumed is approximately the same. Decaffeinated coffee, however, has been found to have slightly less antioxidant capacity than regular caffeinated coffee, likely due to the removal of crude caffeine and its accompanying antioxidant effects. The addition of milk or cream to coffee was also found to decrease the antioxidant activity of coffee. So how do we choose what coffee to research? First, me and Kelly looked up what is the most common brew that Americans drink. We found out French roast was top 5 of the most commonly drank brews. Then we went to Kroger and bought an expensive and less common brand named Pete's Coffee, a more common coffee brand named Folgers, and a little less expensive, and the store's cheaper off-brand type of coffee, Kroger Coffee. We made sure they were all of the same roast to have a consistency, and we did pick French roast. We hypothesized that there would be a significant difference in the antioxidant capacity of different brands of coffee. We compared the antioxidant capacity of each brand using the Trollox equivalent antioxidant capacity, TEAC method. Preparing our coffee. From the granulated coffee bought at the store, per 5 grams, we brewed it with 100 milliliters of distilled water as the master dilution. We did this for each brand. From there, we diluted each brand even further as needed during lab. Each further dilution was then tested with an ABTS solution whose absorbance ranged between 0.750 and 0.850 at 736 nanometers using a spectrophotometer. Fresh ABTS solutions were prepared each week, and the Coffee Master dilutions were kept in the fridge as needed. The absorbance at different concentrations for the different brands were recorded, and the percent inhibition was grand for Pete's Coffee, Folgers Coffee, and Kroger's Coffee. The slope of the trend line from each assay was then divided by the previously found TEAC value of Trollox from class, which was 0.2246, to give the TEAC activity of each sample. A higher TEAC value correlates with a higher total antioxidant capacity. The TEAC value for Kroger brand coffee was the lowest at 995. The TEAC value for Pete's Coffee was slightly higher at 1002. The TEAC value for Folgers was more than 4 times larger than the other two at 4467, indicating a significantly higher antioxidant capacity. Since all three brands were brewed identically, the difference in antioxidant activity must be related to how these beans were harvested or a manufacturing difference. When the percent inhibition of our samples was compared to other research previously done, we noticed that our percent inhibition was a lot lower. The fact that other researchers used coffee beans and not already processed granulated coffee can account for the loss of antioxidant activity. We noticed that Folgers coffee, with the highest antioxidant activity for our sample, was almost half of that of other research. Kroger and Pete's brand were both about 0.11 of other research, as ratio-wise. We do believe, though, since most people brew processed granulated coffee and not eat raw coffee beans, that our results are closer to the amount of antioxidant that people will actually consume.